MSW from Mumbai University in 2002. She has been working with victims trafficked into commercial country Swift Wash, a community-based economic alternative livelihood for victims of sex.
There are about 20 to 40 million in modern slavery as of today. Around 15 million are victims of sex trafficking. 95 are forced. And in India, in 15 minutes, at least one victim is raped. We felt it important on this day of International Day Against Human Trafficking to meet, to discuss, and to see how can we keep Goa safe. Before I begin talking about the whole phenomena and how we together as a society can we work towards keeping Goa safe, I felt it's important that I first begin by sharing a bit about ARTS. ARTS, we are an NGO. We are based in Vasco and we work on the issue of sexual violence. As we know, it is an organized crime. And there we find the victim, the person who is being sexually assaulted, there are more than one person involved in sexually assaulting this victim. Now, talking about sex trafficking, okay, here in the state of Goa, is it a problem? I think most of us, whatever we have seen in the news, we'll say yes, it is a problem. And we at ARTS, we say it's a problem based on the research that we have done. ARTS has done a statistical analysis recently, and we have found that in Goa, you have girls who are being trafficked into Goa from 24 states in India, as well as from the neighboring countries like Bangladesh and Nepal. Our concern is that on this day against trafficking in person, we felt it important to come and to discuss here in Marigaon. Why so? Because if you look at it, when we say 24% of girls are getting trafficked into Goa, from 24 states, girls are getting trafficked into Goa. Here, there is a demand. There is a demand that is created in Goa. And if you look at it, Goa now is being portrayed as a place which is for sexual purpose. The two S in Goa, somewhere it is getting lost. The sun and sand is getting lost when it comes to tourists. Tourists nowadays are coming into Goa mainly for the purpose of sexual services. And Goa is getting portrayed that way. Our concern is that why we have come here again to Marigaon is we are finding that the phenomena of recent, like previously in Goa we had the red light area, which is not there anymore. Then we found it was getting into massage parlors. You had hotels and lodges. But of recent, we are finding that there is a phenomena of the commercial sexual activity being done in residential areas, in flats. Some came back, one of my colleagues had gone with crime branch for a rescue. When a rescue was done, since ours, we are the nodal NGO appointed by Goa Police, usually the Goa Police takes us for the rescue. When we had gone for the rescue with crime branch, the crime branch usually sends a decoy, and the agent who was in contact with the decoy asks the decoy customer to go to a particular location. And where was this location? It was in a posh residential area. When the decoy went, the security looked at the vehicle number and allowed the decoy to go in. But when the police vehicle went, they were stopped. The security asked, kidhar jane ka hai, kyun jane ka, kya hai? So what we are trying to see is that it is organized. And when the police investigated further, it was found that this flat has been given on rent to somebody else. It is given on rent, the owner sitting in Bombay, and who's running, for what purpose it is running, nobody has any idea. Now if you look at Marigaon, what is it in Marigaon? How is it in Marigaon? I think Lorna will also be sharing. Yes, in Marigaon, we do find some women who are standing on the street. They take customers into the low cost lodges. Our concern here in Margao is that we are finding a phenomena of yes in massage parlor as well as the beach area that is here in Margao, which is visited mostly by tourists, which is a tourist destination. Most of the tourists, we are finding it getting organized here. The hotels and lodges are allowing this activity to be carried on. So our concern is that Margao, if it happens, like yesterday when we had the talk in Vasco, we are going to the Rotarian clubs and having it in each of the locations. There in Vasco, we were saying South Goa is safe, it is not like North Goa. We need to see that we are educated. We have information on what is happening around us. We need to be alert. Who is staying? Who is my next door neighbor? Whom am I giving my house on rent to? We need to be alert. We need to know what is happening around us. Most important, I think, what we need to do on this day against human trafficking is somewhere, this year the theme is voices of victims, but I think somewhere what we need to do as a group is let's look at the demand, let's look at this whole issue of sex trafficking not from the social point of view, that girls are coming in because there is poverty, they are coming in because there is some problem at home. Let us look at it from an organized crime point of view, that how do we ensure that they are not allowing, they are not using our premises for such activities, and it is not being used to commercially sexually exploit women. I think it's high time that we all work together. Let us be alert, let us raise our voice, and let us see how do we keep our area safe, keep Goa safe from becoming like Thailand, as one of the participants were sharing with me, is that yeah, we need to see how Goa does not become Thailand. And I think if we don't raise our voice, if we don't come up, it is not going to happen. We just cannot depend upon police and NGOs to take a stand and do things. It is us public that we come up, we be alert, we speak up, and we prevent and keep Goa safe. And I would like to end by saying is that I think it's high time that we all take up a stand, we raise our voice and we say it's enough and we need to start working and keeping Goa safe. Thank you.
Put them up. So we also looked at trade as such. If you, we had gone on to some websites which we found kind of the, what you call it, the trafficking websites. Which actually give great details about girls that are available. I've actually printed out something this morning only by going on the website. Like, they're actually giving the age of the girl, the weight of the girl, what she looks like, the measurements of her thing, what she will do, you know, the services she will provide, the charges she will take, all of this. And each village has a separate topic, like they say escorts in Margao and details about that, escorts in Benauli, details about that, you know, escorts in Kolwa, details about that. So if you, every village has the girls, and in some of the, on some of them they even have names mentioned of the girls. When we found this website in 2017, we actually petitioned the governor, the government authorities, the police and all of them. We also had a meeting with the governor saying, you know, these websites need to be stopped. But we did not get very, very good cooperation either from the DGP or from the authorities. The governor was trying to kind of like push, you know, to say we need to stop these websites. And they kept saying, no, when we tell them to stop the websites, the people in Delhi kind of laugh at us. You know, we cannot stop these websites at all. So, of course, that was, it was not very acceptable to us, that answer. But we were stuck with that thing, you know, when they said they cannot do it. But I found that in later on, that those websites that were there, their names have changed. You know, so they've shut down those websites and they've created newer websites. you know, so they are promoting this trafficking and the sexual activity for people. We have also found out that there are not a lot of tenant verifications being done. We read in the newspapers when people are bought for trafficking, you know, the pimps or whoever they are living there, or even the girls who are staying in the apartment, their tenant verification is not done. So nobody is aware of who they are or where they have come from or things like that. And this tenant verification is a good example of what has happened in this today's papers about this case in Kepe. This girl has been brought from Assam, and I'm sure the tenant verification and things have not been done with her. And that is a classic case of trafficking of a woman. You know, we have not given them license to function, so how can we stop them? Which is a ridiculous statement, because who's going to give a license to run a sexual activity? You know, instead of looking at it from a proactive point of view, you know, I would say that let us stop. Yeah, I even sent her these details of what was on the website about Margaon, and saying about Margaon housewives, the housewives of Margaon, and the women of Margaon, and the college students. And there are many colleges in Margaon. We wrote even to the colleges, but we did not get a response from any of them, you know, to our petition to say, why don't you yourself write and ask them to shut down this website, because they are saying such bad things about our girls, you know, the girls in the colleges, the housewives. So it can happen so that when after some time the tourists will come on the streets while we are walking and say, you know, come with me. I can see the situation happening. The village, even though we support that statement that minors should not be out late at night on their own, maybe they need to go with the parents, but we actually, the Goa Women's Forum is like strongly condemning that these statements that they make, you know, that the girls were dressed in a particular way, that's why they invited the attention, or you know, of how the woman was dressed, or how she's inviting the attention to herself. Even though we have to actually look at the root cause, or what is the reason why this is happening.